Hello friends, welcome back to our channel Geologica. Today in this video we are going to talk about the Walther's law of stratigraphic correlation or the Walther's law of phases. So what we will see, what is the definition of Walther's law and how we utilize this for the correlation of stratigraphic units. But before we begin, you can join our Telegram channel, that is Geologica 2020, so that you will be notified about the latest notification, and you can also contact me through the Instagram ID. So let's begin with the basic definition. So according to definition, Walther's law is a vertical sequence which represents the phases that were once laterally continuous. So just simple one line statement, it is saying that suppose that we have three phases A, B and C. So these three phases, initially they are laterally continuous. But we are getting them as vertical sequence like A, B, C, or it can be reversed like C, B, A. So a vertical sequence we are getting, let me change the color. So a vertical sequence we are getting which were initially laterally continuous. So this is the Walther's law statement. Now let us see with a very fundamental example how these lateral phases can be converted into the vertical one. So let us assume that we have an ocean floor like this, and we have three phases. One is here, let us denoted by A, B, C and D. Okay. Then what will happen? Initially the ocean is something like this, oceanic surface. Then let us assume a condition, that is transgression, the rising of sea level. So the sea level is rising. Now sea level is reached somewhere here. Then what will happen? The rock sequences, which A is here, now A will reach on this position and B will reach on this position, and the rocks of phases C will now be there and D will be there. Okay. Now let us assume with further transgression and sea level is continues to rise, and now it is somewhere here. Okay. Then what will happen? Then again the same condition. Now A is shifted again in this side, and now B will be become here. And let me choose the black color again. Okay. So then C will shift towards here, D will shift towards here. Now you got my point. Initially A, B, C and D, these were laterally continuous. Okay. Now because of transgressive in nature of ocean, we are getting these horizontal phase sequences as an upward or the vertical thickening. So this is the condition how the phases are developed from a horizontal layer to the vertical sequences. This is the Walther's law what states. Now if we have reversed the situation, this was the condition of marine transgression, the rising of sea level. Now if we talk about the marine regression, then the reverse situation will be happened. Okay. So I hope you got the basic concept how these phases are developed. Okay. You can revise back this video if you are still, if you have any doubt. Now let us see the image portion. So this is, I have taken from the various online sources. So here it is the condition of regression, that is decreasing of sea level or falling of sea level. Okay. So this pattern, when the shoreline moves seaward due to an excess sediment supply from the land, or when the land is tectonically uplifted. So as you can see, the horizontal rock sequences are like this, A, B and C. But because of this downward movement of sea level, we are getting the B here above the A. This is the A sequence. Now we are getting B sequence above the A. So this is the convert of horizontal faces into the vertical layers. So this is the application of Walther's law. Now let us see another example of transgression. So this is the image showing the transgression. Here the same thing, you can see that faces are here like A, B and C. What you will get here, now above C, this yellow one, you are getting the B faces, that is gray one. So C, B, and after that we will get A. So again here the sequence, before it was horizontal, now we are getting it vertical. So this is the application of Walther's law. Now there are also limitation. Walther's law of faces can be applied only when the sequences are conformable, means there should not be any unconformity. Okay, if there is unconformity, that means there is any change in sediment supply or the break in sediment supply or there is erosion happening. So that is the different case. So if we are getting any sequences which should be horizontal, A, B and C, so we can say that these were once horizontal. Okay, sometimes we get the shallow marine faces at the bottom and the deep marine faces on the top. So we will confuse, what, how is this possible to get deep marine faces on the top and shallow marine faces on the bottom? So this is nothing, this is the result of marine regression and transgression, and simply we will apply Walther's law and we will arrange these rock sequences. So I hope you all get everything about the Walther's law of faces. Thank you.